home where the buffalo roam, where the deer and the antelope play, where seldom is heard a discouraging word, and the sky is not cloudy all day. A home, a home, where the deer and the antelope play, where seldom is heard a discouraging word, and the sky is not clouded all day. Oh, give me a land where the bright diamond sand throws its light from the glittering stream, where glideth along the graceful white swan like the maid in her heavenly dream. A home, a home, where the deer and the antelope play, where seldom is heard a discouraging word, and the sky not clouded all day. Oh, give me a gale of the Solomon Vale, where the life streams with buoyancy flow, on the banks of the Beaver, where seldom if ever any poisonous herbage doth grow. A home, a home, where the deer and the antelope play, where seldom is heard a discouraging word, and the sky is not clouded all day. How often at night, when the heavens were bright with the light of the twinkling stars, have I stood here amazed and asked as I gaze if their glory exceed that of ours. A home, a home, where the deer and the antelope play, where seldom is heard a discouraging word, and the sky is not clouded all day. I love the wildflowers in this bright land of ours. I love the wild curlew, shrill scream, the bluffs and white rocks, and the antelope flocks that graze on the mountains so green. A home, a home, where the deer and the antelope play, where seldom is heard a discouraging word, and the sky is not clouded all day. The air so pure, and the breeze is so
bride.
A home, a home, where the deer and the antelope play, where seldom is heard a discouraging word, and the sky is not clouded all day.
My grandfather's plot was too large for the shelf, so it stood 90 years on the floor. It was taller by half than the old man himself, though it weighed not a penny weight more. It was bought on the morn of the day that he was born, and was always his treasure and pride. But it stopped short, never to go again when the old man died. 90 years without slumbering, his life sentence numbering. It stopped short, never to go again when the old man died. Watching its pendulum swing to and fro, many hours had he spent while a boy. And in childhood and manhood the clock seemed to know, and to share both his grief and his joy. For it struck 24 when he entered at the door with the blooming and beautiful bride. But it stopped short, never to go again when the old man died. 90 years without slumbering, his life seconds numbering. It stopped short, never to go again when the old man died. No time, and had but one desire at the close of each week to be wound, and kept in its place not a frown upon its face, and its hands never hung by its side. But it stopped short, never to go again when the old man died. 90 years without slumbering, his life seconds numbering. It stopped short, never to go again when the old man died. It rang an alarm in the dead of the night, an alarm that for years had been dumb. His spirit was blooming for flight, that his hour of departure had come. Still the clock kept the time with the soft and muffled chime, as we silently stood by his side. But it stopped short, never to go again when the old. His life seconds numbering. It stopped short, never to to go again when the old man died. It stopped short, never to go again when the old man died.